Hello everyone. So today we are continuing our discussion from lift problems. Last class we had started lift problems, but there itself I mentioned that there are two types of problems in lift. One giving only one weight, that is the weight of the person or the weight of the lift. In the second type of problem, there will be two weights given, the weight of the man and the weight of the lift. So we'll be dealing with the second type of problems in this section. An elevator of mass 500 kilogram is ascending with an acceleration of 3 meter per second square. So an elevator is there, its mass is 500 kilogram. The elevator mass is 500 kilogram. It is ascending. Ascending means it's moving upwards with an acceleration of 3 meter per second square. Small letter a is given. During this ascent, its operator, whose mass is 70 kilogram, there is a man standing there. His mass is 70 kilogram. He is standing on a scale placed on the floor. Right? He is standing on this on a scale. Scale means the weighing scale. So what is the weight shown in the scale reading? Okay, and what will be the total tension? So definitely this is the second type of problem because two masses are given, right? So what we do is we draw the free body diagram. We know the lift as such, if we take, tension is more upward. 500 kilogram, the weight of the elevator is more downwards, and there is a 3 meter per second square acceleration upward. And inside the lift, there is a man whose mass is 70 kilogram. Since he is having contact with the surface, there will be definitely a reactive force, capital letter R. So to solve these problems, it is very simple actually. Suppose we need to find out the scale reading. Okay, so scale reading means the man's scale reading. So what we need to do is we consider a system. We don't think about the lift and all. We consider a system like this only, that is a man, his scale reading and the movement. Okay. So for such a case, to find the scale reading, we consider only a man of mass 70 kilogram, the reactive force R, and of course he is moving upwards with the acceleration of 3 meter per second square. So we can apply D'Alembert's principle here. So how to apply? The forces in the direction of motion is positive. So R minus 70 into 9.81 equal to 70 into 3. So we can get the R value 896.7 Newton. So this R value is the scale reading or the weight shown in the scale. Okay. To find the tension in the cable. So this time, since we have to find out the tension, we take the whole system as such. So here the lift, if we take, tension T is acting upward. What is downward weight? There is definitely 500 kilogram, but is that sufficient? No, because there is a man 70 kilogram. So the total mass acting downwards is 500 plus 70, and the movement is upward, 3 meter per second square. So we know how to write the D'Alembert's principle. T minus 500 plus 70 into 9.81 equal to M into, M is actually 570 into 9.81. Upon solving, we will get tension equal to 7301.7 Newton. So I think this is clear. So the next question, an elevator of gross mass 500 kilogram starts moving upwards. So the movement is also given, moving upwards with a constant acceleration, and acquires a velocity of 2 meter per second after traveling a distance of 3 meter. So here itself we can identify why this velocity and distance is given. So find the pull in the cables during the accelerated motion. If the elevator when stopping moves with a constant deceleration from a constant velocity of 2 meter per second and comes to rest in 2 seconds, calculate the force transmitted by a man of mass 75 kilogram on the floor during the stopping. So it's a very there are two or three questions linked to it. So we'll take one by one. So elevator gross mass is given 500 kilogram. It is starting moving with a constant acceleration, but we are not given the acceleration, but we can find out the acceleration. That is why the first part of the question has some clues. That is, it acquires a velocity of 2 meter per second after traveling a distance of 3 meters. So while the lift is moving. So as the lift is moving, we know the lift as such, it will be starting from rest, right? And it will be acquiring a velocity of to some velocity. Okay. So if we need to find out the acceleration, we are given u, or it is starting from rest, u equal to 0, v equal to 2 meter per second, and the time taken for that is also given. Time taken is also given, I think. So we can find out acceleration from the equations of motion. So sorry, the time is not given, the distance is given. So which equation we have to use? V square equal to u square plus 2as, and v square equal to 2 square, u square equal to 0 square plus 2 into a into 3. This is the distance. So acceleration will be 0.67 meter per second square. So we now found out what is the acceleration. So we can find out from the D'Alembert's principle, t minus 500. 500 is mass. So t minus 500 into 9.8 equal to mass into acceleration. Mass is 500 into acceleration 0.67. So tension equal to 5235 newton. So this answers the first part. Find the pull in the cables during the accelerated motion. Okay, so that we have found out. Now the next case, if the elevator when stopping, so suppose the elevator moves through a distance and now it is time for it to stop, that means it has reached some level. Okay, so some first floor or second floor it has reached. So how does that happen? It starts braking, right? The pulleys will exert a force and it starts braking. So suppose so here the lift goes on acceleration or deceleration. It goes through a deceleration, right? So if the elevator when stopping moves with a constant deceleration, so we have a deceleration from a constant velocity of 2 meter per second. So what is 2 meter per second here? So here in the case 2, u equal to 2 meter per second, the initial velocity is 2 meter per second, and comes to rest in 2 seconds. So what is the final velocity? Since it goes to rest, final velocity equal to 0, and this happens in a time gap of 2 seconds. So t equal to 2 seconds. Calculate the force transmitted by a man of 75 kilogram on the floor during stopping. So we'll frame that question. What is the force transmitted by a man of mass 75 kilogram on the floor during stopping? So that is on this elevator there is a man of 75 kilogram, and what is the force transmitted by the man on the floor? That means if the man is standing on a weighing scale, what is the scale reading? They are actually asking that only. So it is similar to the earlier problem we have discussed. So as I discussed in the earlier problem, if we need to find out the force transmitted by the man, we need not think about the whole system. We can break down into the smaller system. That is, the man is right here, his weight is 75 kilogram, and there is a reactive force of R, and acceleration we don't know still, but we can find out. Okay, so how do we write the equation here? Acceleration, actually I have found out, I'll show you how it is being found out. So but how the equation is being wrote? Acceleration is towards the upward side, so R minus 75 into 9.81 equal to 70 mass into acceleration, 75 into something. So acceleration, how we find out? We know deceleration, u equal to 2 meter per second, v equal to 0, and time equal to 2 seconds. So from the first equation of motion, v equal to u plus at, right? So v equal to 0, u equal to 2, a2 equal to minus 1 meter per second. The minus sign signifies that it is deceleration. So don't think it is a wrong answer and all, and never neglect that. It is definitely required for finding out the answer. So a equal to minus 1 meter per second square. So we substitute that here, and finally reactive force equal to 660 newton, or the weight acted by the man on the floor is equal to 660 newton. Okay, so that is with problems from lift. So please practice more problems from your textbooks. Anyway, it will be a combination of these two type of problems only, the lift motion as I discussed. Only these kind of problems will be coming for exam. So thank you.